Hello students, we are going to discuss about material balance with the chemical reaction problem continuation. Fourth problem, ethylene oxide is produced by oxidation of ethylene. So 100 kmol of ethylene fed to a reactor. Product contains 80 kmol of ethylene oxide and 10 kmol of carbon dioxide. Objective of this problem, percentage conversion and percentage yield of ethylene and ethylene oxide. Are you clear or not? Okay. So solution of this problem, you should write basis. Basis of this problem, 100 kmol of ethylene. So as per the problem, you should draw a block diagram. So which equipment used here? As per the problem, reactor acting as a unit operation here. So the ethylene and oxygen is a reactant fed to a reactor to produce the products or ethylene oxide, carbon dioxide and water. So some unwanted components also present in a product side. So what are the unwanted components or unreacted components? Ethylene and oxygen. Are you clear or not? Okay. So the how many components are present in a product side? Ethylene oxide is the main product. Carbon dioxide is a side product. Water is a side product. Ethylene is a unreacted component. Oxygen is a unreacted component. Totally 5 components are present in a product stream. Are you clear or not? Okay. So as per the problem, you should write chemical reaction. Ethylene reacted with oxygen to produce ethylene oxide. So ethylene plus half O2 gives C2H4O. This is the ethylene oxide reaction. This is the main reaction. So what about the side reaction? So when the components are react with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. But here the ethylene is a reactant. So definitely this is produced the carbon dioxide and water because this is the combustion reaction. Are you clear? We have two reactions as per the problem. Reaction number 1, ethylene to produce ethylene oxide. Reaction number 2, ethylene to produce carbon dioxide and water. So from the reaction number 1 kmol of ethylene oxide produce 1 kmol of ethylene is required. So as per the problem, how much kmol of ethylene oxide is present in a product side? 80 kmol. So 80 kmol of ethylene oxide present in product side, how much kmol of ethylene is needed? 80 into 1 by 1, 80 kmol of ethylene. So ethylene reacted 80 kmol. So reaction number 2, so as per the reaction, 2 kmol of carbon dioxide produced means 1 kmol of ethylene is reacted. So as per the problem, 10 kmol of carbon dioxide produced means how much kmol of ethylene is reacted? 10 into 1 by 2, that is equal to 5 kmol. So ethylene reacted, that is equal to 5 kmol. So ethylene totally reacted. How will you find out totally reacted? We have the two reaction, reaction number 1, reaction number 2. From reaction number 1, ethylene reacted 80. From reaction number 2, ethylene reacted 5. So the totally reacted 80 plus 5, 85 kmol. So the percentage conversion of ethylene is equal to ethylene totally reacted by ethylene feed into 100. So the totally reacted calculated value 85. Ethylene feed is the given data 100 multiplied by 100. Finally we get percentage conversion of ethylene is equal to 85. Are you clear or not? Okay, this is the first question. Second question, percentage yield of ethylene oxide. So the formula, ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide divided by ethylene totally reacted multiplied by 100. So ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide. Which reaction? Reaction number 1. From the reaction number 1, ethylene reacted is equal to 80 kmol. So this is the calculated value divided by ethylene totally reacted. from reaction number 1 and reaction number 2, summation of these two value, finally we have 85. Are you clear or not? Okay. So the 80 from reaction number 1, 5 from reaction number 2, totally 85 kilomoles of ethylene is reacted. Multiply by 100, finally we get percentage yield of ethylene oxide is equal to 94.12. So this is the second expression. Fifth question. Ethylene oxide is prepared by oxidation of ethylene. 100 kmol of ethylene and 100 kmol of oxygen are fed to a reactor. Percentage conversion of ethylene is 85. Percentage yield of ethylene oxide is 94.12. Objective of this problem, determine composition of products in leaving the reactor. Consider the below reaction. Two reactions are given. Reaction number 1, ethylene to produce ethylene oxide. Reaction number 2, ethylene to produce carbon dioxide and water. Are you clear or not? Okay. So the question of this problem, determine the composition of product stream leaving the reactor. So as per the problem, the two equations are given. So one is the ethylene oxide production from ethylene. Second one, carbon dioxide produced from ethylene. Are you clear or not? Okay. So the given data, 100 kmol of ethylene, 100 kmol of oxygen fed to a reactor. So then percentage conversion of ethylene is given 85. Percentage yield of ethylene oxide is given 94.12. Are you clear or not? Okay. Yes. So here, first step, you should write basis. So basis of this problem, 100 kmol of ethylene and 100 kmol of oxygen. Are you clear or not? Okay. So as per the problem, you should draw a block diagram. So the which equipment are used here? As per the condition of this problem, we are going to choose the reactor. So why? Because ethylene and oxygen kilomoles are fed to a reactor. So here reactant ethylene and oxygen. So the both components are 100 kilomoles entering into a reactor. So the product leaving from the reactor, ethylene oxide, then ethylene, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water. So here 5 components are there. From these 5 components, ethylene oxide is the main product, carbon dioxide and water is the side product, oxygen and ethylene is the unreacted component or unwanted component present in a product side. Are you clear or not? Okay, these are the unreacted components. Percentage conversion of ethylene is equal to 85. From this percentage conversion, we are going to calculate ethylene totally reacted value. Percentage conversion of ethylene is equal to ethylene totally reacted divided by ethylene feed into 100. So here percentage conversion of ethylene is known, ethylene feed is known, substitute these two value, find out ethylene totally reacted. So the finally we get ethylene totally reacted 85 kmol. Are you clear or not? Okay. Yes. So additional data are given, percentage yield of ethylene oxide, that is equal to 94.12. From these value, we are going to calculate how much ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide. Why? Because we have only ethylene totally reacted. So we don't know how much ethylene reacted by reaction 1, how much ethylene reacted by reaction 2. We are going to calculate with the help of percentage yield of ethylene oxide. Percentage yield of ethylene oxide formula, ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide whole divided by ethylene totally reacted into 100. So here percentage yield of ethylene oxide is equal to 94.12. Ethylene totally reacted value, already calculated value 85. So the multiply by 100, from this we are going to calculate ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide, that is equal to 80 kmol. Why? Because so this is the reaction number 1. So the ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide. Moles of ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide by reaction number 1, 80 kilomole. So moles of ethylene reacted by reaction number 2, how will you calculate? Totally reacted we know, is right, that is a calculated value. The total value minus with ethylene reacted by reaction 1, that is equal to ethylene reacted by reaction 2. So the 85 minus 80, that is equal to 5 kilomole. From reaction number 1, so the what is the reaction number 1? Ethylene reacted to produce ethylene oxide. So we have 5 components. We are going to calculate the 5 component composition value. So the first we are going to concentrate ethylene oxide produced. Why? Because so this is the our main product. So the how will we calculate ethylene oxide produced value? As per the reaction, so we are going to consider the first reaction. As per the reaction, 1 kilomole of ethylene is produced 1 kilomole of ethylene oxide. So as per the problem, 80 kilomole of ethylene is reacted, how much kilomole of ethylene oxide is produced? So the ethylene oxide produced is equal to 80 kilomole. Are you clear on that? Okay, the first component is over. This is our main product. So the main product produced from reaction number 1. Are you clear or not? Okay. So next we are going to concentrate unreacted component. What are the unreacted component? One is ethylene, another one is oxygen. First we are going to discuss ethylene unreacted value. So you should write the material balance of ethylene. Ethylene feed is equal to ethylene reacted plus ethylene unreacted. Ethylene feed is given data 100, ethylene reacted value by reaction number 1 85 plus ethylene unreacted value. So we are going to calculate. So the ethylene unreacted is equal to ethylene feed minus ethylene reacted value, that is equal to 15 kilomole. Are you clear on that? Okay, this is from reaction number 1. So by reaction number 1, next we are going to concentrate another unreacted component, oxygen. As per the reaction, 1 kilomole of ethylene is required, half kilomole of oxygen by reaction number 1. So the reaction number 1, how much kilomole of ethylene is reacted? 80 kilomole. So the 80 kilomole of ethylene is reacted mean, how much kilomole of oxygen is required? 80 into 1 by 2 divided by 1, oxygen reacted by reaction number 1, 40 kilomole. By reaction number 2, 1 kilomole of ethylene is equal to 3 kilomole of oxygen. As per the reaction, 1 kilomole of ethylene is required 3 kilomole of oxygen. As per the problem, by reaction 2, how many kilomoles of ethylene is reacted? 5 kilomole. So the 5 kilomole of ethylene is reacted mean how much kilomole of oxygen is reacted or required? So the oxygen reacted is equal to 3 into 5 divided by 1, that is equal to 15 kilomole. This is by reaction number 2. But oxygen utilized in both reaction. So the reaction number 1 and reaction number 2. So but we want oxygen totally reacted value. So the reaction number 1 40 kilomole, reaction number 2 15 kilomole, 40 plus 15, that is equal to 55 kilomole. So oxygen feed is equal to oxygen reacted plus oxygen unreacted value. Why? Because this is the oxygen material balance. We don't want the reacted value, we want unreacted value. So what do you do here? Oxygen feed is known, that is a given data 100. Oxygen reacted, this is totally reacted value 55. Substitute here. From this expression, we want to calculate oxygen unreacted value. That is equal to 45 kilomole. Are you clear or not? Okay, now we have three components. One is ethylene oxide produced, another is ethylene unreacted, third one is oxygen unreacted component. Are you clear or not? Okay, so but we are going to concentrate rest of the component. One is carbon dioxide, another one is water. So the carbon dioxide and water is produced from reaction number 2. So that's why we are going to concentrate reaction number 2. By reaction 2, as per the reaction, 1 kilomole of ethylene is required 2 kilomole of carbon dioxide. Are you clear on that? Okay. So 1 kilomole of ethylene is reacted to produce 2 kilomole of carbon dioxide. So as per the problem, how much kilomole of ethylene is reacted? 5 kilomole. So 5 kilomole of ethylene is reacted means how much kilomole of carbon dioxide is produced? 5 into 2 divided by 1, 10 kilomole of carbon dioxide. Finally, carbon dioxide produced 10 kilomole. Are you clear or not? Okay, this is by reaction number 2. So from reaction number 2, how much water is produced? So as per the reaction, 1 kilomole of ethylene is produced 2 kilomole of water. So in reaction number 2, how much kilomole of ethylene is reacted as per the problem? 5 kilomole of ethylene. So the 5 kilomole of ethylene is reacted mean how much kilomole of water is produced? 5 into 2 by 1, 10 kilomole of water. Water produced is equal to 10 kilomole. Are you clear or not? Okay, now we have 5 components. One is ethylene oxide produced, another one ethylene unreacted, third one oxygen unreacted, fourth one carbon dioxide produced, fifth one water produced. Are you clear or not? Okay. This is the result of this problem. Objective of this problem, determine the composition of products T. So this is the mole basis. What are the components present in a product size? 3 products, 2 unreacted components. So the 1 is the main product, 2 is the side product. So here 5 components are there. You should make a table. Here components, first one is the ethylene. This is the unreacted component, 15 kilomole. Ethylene oxide is the main product. Ethylene oxide produce 80 kilomole. Oxygen unreacted value 45 kilomole. Carbon dioxide produced value 10 kilomole. This is the side product. Water also side product. This is 10 kilomole. The total mole 15 plus 80 plus 45 plus 10 plus 10, totally 160. So the first we are going to calculate mole percentage of ethylene. What is the formula? Mole percentage, individual mole divided by total mole n to 100. So here individual mole 15, total mole that is 160. 15 divided by 160 into 100, 9.38. Ethylene oxide 80 divided by 160 into 100, 50. Third one oxygen 45 divided by 160 into 100, 28.12. Similarly, carbon dioxide 10 divided by 160 into 100, 6.25. So the water 10 divided by 160 into 100, 6.25. The total percentages are 100. You add all these component mole percentages value, finally we get 100%. So the whether the problem is right or wrong, how will you check? Finally, you get 100% value. That is a mole percentage, or approximately 100. So that's why your problem is right. Okay. So thank you for your attention.